Hey, welcome back to CoinStore's Candlestick Chart series. Previously, we've learned about the evolution and implications of candlestick charts, where we went through the different parts and commonly seen candlesticks. Today, we will be learning about how to apply bullish candlestick chart patterns. More specifically, the Morningstar pattern, bullish engulfing pattern, and the tower bottom pattern. As illustrated with the red line in the figure, a standard Morningstar pattern is composed of three candlesticks. It includes a long red line, which is followed by a star line that resembles a cross, and a long green candle. A Morningstar can be identified by observing the long green candle. The closing price of the candle has to be 50% higher than the price of the previous red candle's body. Through the Morningstar pattern, we are able to judge the bullish strength within the market by the position of the closing price of the green candle. Here are a few figures to help you visualize. If the closing price of the green candle exceeds the requirement of being 50% higher, this means that the bullish strength is relatively weak. If the closing price of the green candle is equal to the opening price of the previous red line, this means that the bullish strength is strong. If the closing price of the subsequent green candle is significantly higher than the opening price of the previous red candle, this means that the bullish strength is very strong. What I've just mentioned are some of the few most standard Morningstar patterns. But what's the Morningstar like in the market? Here are three figures to illustrate. This Morningstar pattern resembles the dragonfly pattern. When the price drops sharply, the Morningstar appears and the price rallies. In the second figure, there are two short candles. When the Morningstar appears on the uptrend, it will subsequently continue to rise. In the third figure, there are three short candles or star candlestick patterns. When the Morningstar appears, the price will drop sharply until it stops falling and rebounds. And with that, we are finally done with the Morningstar candlestick pattern. Next, we will be learning about the bullish engulfing pattern. Firstly, let's take a look at its characteristics. The body of the green candle covers the previous red candle's body, as though the red candle is engulfed by the green. The existence of a bullish engulfing pattern tends to signify trend reversals, causing analysts to pay particular attention to them. So, how do you gauge the bullish strength of a bullish engulfing pattern? One example is the body of the green candle engulfing the body of the previous red candle. This indicates that the bullish strength is weak. When the body of the green candle is significantly higher than that of the previous red candle's body, or even double its size, this indicates that the bullish strength is strong. When the body of the green candle engulfs many red lines in front of it, this means that the bullish strength is very strong. As illustrated in the figures, the green line does not have to completely engulf the shadow of the previous red candles. Just like the Morningstar pattern, the bullish engulfing pattern looks different in the actual market. So, how does it actually look like? A bullish engulfing pattern usually appears after the coin market plunges, indicating a sharp rebound. The pattern can also appear when the long green candle engulfs two short red candles, launching a wave of an upward trend. Another example would be when the green candle engulfs three red candles in one go, creating a sharp rise in the market. Now that we have learned about two bullish candlestick combinations, let's move on to the final candlestick pattern, the tower bottom pattern. So, how does a tower bottom pattern look like? There are three parts to this candle. On the left of the tower bottom, there is a medium red candle or a long red candle. The middle is composed of several short candles, which usually adds up to more than five. On the right, there is a medium green candle or a long green candle. Together, these candles look like an upside-down tower, which is where its name comes from. To qualify as a tower bottom, the closing price of the previous green candle has to exceed the body of the previous long red candle by 50%. The tower bottom shows a process of the selling short force being gradually weakened, whether the long short forces are balanced, and when the upward trend is enhanced. Through this, we are able to judge the bullish strength by the position of the closing price of the previous green candle. Here are a few examples. If the closing price of the green candle exceeds the previous long red candle by 50%, this signifies a relatively weak bullish strength. If the closing price of the green candle is equal to the opening price of the previous red candle, this signifies a stronger bullish strength. Now, let's take a look at the tower bottom pattern in the market. There are two variations. Variation 1 The actual appearance is very close to the schematic diagram of a tower bottom. The appearance of a tower bottom pattern states a rising advantage in the uptrend, launching a sharp increase in the market. Variation 2, the middle portion of the tower bottom is not totally composed of short candles that will fluctuate greatly. This will cause a large bottom to form after the price falls sharply, after which the price will rebound. We've come to the end of the session. Today, we have learned about three typical bullish candlestick patterns. The Morningstar pattern, which indicates light. The bullish engulfing pattern, where the longer candle engulfs the shorter candle. The tower bottom candle indicates a bullish trend reversal. And that's a wrap for this session anyway. Come back next week to learn about how to predict bearish trends by observing candlestick graphs. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos like this. Also, don't forget to click the notification bell button below to stay updated when we post a new video. Bye!